All right. We are back here at Song of the Day, coming to you from the Rock Cave. I'm your host, Mark Pierce. It's Thursday, Thirsty Thursday. For those of you who are thirsty, it is Thursday. All right, we just wrapped up three episodes of Woodstock 99 with guest host Paul Chabot back in the cave again. What a great time that was. 30 minutes talking about the debacle of Woodstock 99. Still scratching our heads wondering, did anyone have a good time? It's much better to watch the videos of those performances than to have been there. So if you have some time, go ahead and click on those links and check it out, because there are some performances there that are pretty cool, but to have been there, no thank you. Thank you, Paul, for doing that. What are we talking about today? I think it's just, I've got lists everywhere. I've got song, all kinds of ideas. And I just was going to do some classic rock, and I heard this song the other day. I was like, I don't think we've covered this. I don't remember covering this. So let's see. We're talking about the band Free. You knew that already because you clicked on it. Free, English band formed in 1968 by teenagers Paul Rodgers, Paul Kossoff, Andy Fraser, and Simon Kirk. Paul Rodgers and Simon Kirk were 18 years old. Andy Fraser was 15 years old, and Paul Kossoff was 17 years old. They formed this band. Kossoff saw Paul Rodgers with his band, Brown Sugar, I wonder what that was named after, at the Fickle Pickle. And I only mention that because what a name that is. The Fickle Pickle in London, not to be confused with the Regal Beagle here in the United States. And by, they had a first album in 1969 in March, 6 months later. This was after they had the album coming out. I don't know how this all worked out, but they ended up opening up for The Who in 1968 and The Crazy World of Arthur Brown, if you remember the song Fire, personal favorite of mine. But they, in anticipation of turning that record out, they managed to open up in a small tour with The Who in late 68. That album didn't really go anywhere. 1969, second record on Island Records, that did not go anywhere. Third album, they stuck to it, Fire and Water, and that's when they hit pay dirt. 1970, massive success with the song All Right Now, went to the number two in the UK, number four in the United States. The album went to number two in the UK, number 17 in the US. This is a song I heard, it's so great. By 1989, it had been played over 1 million times in the United States, and by 2000, it had played over 2 million times in the UK. We're going to get back to that, but they put out a fourth album. Again, that didn't end up going anywhere. And then the usual, like, people kind of coming in and out, trying to put some stuff out, but they disbanded in 1971. Let's talk about Paul Rodgers for just a minute. For those of you who are not in the know, Paul Rodgers, he's in Free, so you got to listen to All Right Now. Then this happens. They disband in 71. Jim Morrison dies in 1971. And the story is that Robbie Krieger flew over to meet with him and say, hey, do you want to sing with us and essentially replace Jim Morrison? Think about that for a minute. How the rock and roll universe would have changed if Paul Rodgers took over with the Doors. I don't know what to say about that. 2 years later, 1973, Ian Gillan leaves Deep Purple, and they ask him to join Deep Purple. Boy, this guy is really wanted, right? He goes solo. He says, no, I'm going to do my own thing. Then he forms Bad Company. Of course, Bad Company, he takes Simon Kirk on drums with him. And then he takes the bassist from King Crimson, Boz Burnell, and who else was in there? Someone else. Anyway, they were signed to Led Zeppelin's label, Swan Song, the first artist to be signed on there, and off they were going. So, the voice on All Right Now is the same voice on all your favorite Bad Company songs, Feel Like Making Love, Shooting Star, all that stuff. Same voice. Hear it now when you listen. Of course you do. Bad Company breaks up. He goes solo in 83, put out some records. There's this Arms concert with Jeff Beck, Eric Clapton, Joe Cocker, Paul Rodgers, Jimmy Page, Steve Winwood, and that's pretty common, pretty amazing concert for to benefit MS. And through that, he ends up forming the band The Firm, right? Supergroup The Firm with Page, drummer Chris Slade from Manfred Mann, who do Wah Diddy, who would later drum on 8 AC/DC records, including that great song and album with Thunderstruck on it, Razor's Edge, and Tony Franklin. The Firm, of course, Radioactive, Satisfaction Guaranteed, all those great songs. That's Paul Rodgers, people. Paul Rodgers, arguably now one of the best vocalists in rock, classic rock history. Do people even talk about him? They should. Amazing, amazing voice. Really, really incredible. Later, he would tour with Queen. He didn't join Queen. It was Queen plus Paul Rodgers, and they put out a live record of Queen songs and Bad Company songs and all this stuff. But that was pretty cool. So Paul Rodgers, pretty amazing. But we're going all the way back to Free in 1968 formed, and in that third record in 1970, Fire and Water. And the song is All Right. Now, I hear this song, and no wonder it's been played 1 million times here and 2 million in the UK. It's so good. I don't get tired of this song. It's one of those songs you play, and you leave it on. Maybe you turn it down a little bit, but you leave it on. You're singing it. I mean, who doesn't like this song? This is a great song. Gotta love it. Bringing it back here today in the cave. Give it a listen and see what you think. Remember it? You love it? Comment below. Whatever you're doing today, I hope it involves music. And as usual, I'll catch you on the flip side. All right.